planet her, women are the greatest thing to ever happen to this earth. Yeah. So yes, we are listening to Planet Her, the deluxe edition. I am super excited. I have heard the singles, obviously. I've heard Need to Know and Kiss Me More. But I've also heard Love to Dream. I've heard a little snippet that she played on her Instagram.
Let me calm down.
I am so excited to get to that song because from what I heard on the Instagram, I'm 80. That song is gonna own my ass. I'm telling you that right now. Like, do I just get it tattooed? Like, do y'all need to see? Is it already there? Is it already there? Tell me. Is it already there? Because I think it is. Starting off Planet Her with a song called Woman feels right.
Battery low. Please charge now.
Yo, why does she sound a little bit like Rihanna right there? Does she not? You hear what I'm hearing? I am making the executive decision that Doja needs to release a deluxe edition. That was hard to say. That has Nicki on it and has Miss Queen Rihanna. Miss Queen Avon. I can be a woman. Expecting the album to start this way. I thought we were just gonna get right into it and she was just gonna hit me with bar after bar after bar. This is a nice little sultry introduction, I guess, into what like being a woman is. Women just are great. I don't know what else to tell you. Lyrics, Apple Music. I could be the CEO just like a Robin Fenty. It's meant to be. Let's finish off this track real quick. Don't tell them when we succeed and for no reason. They wanna see us end up like we Regina or Mean Girls. Call them out. Why is the industry, why do people want to pit women against each other? Why can't we just breathe? They want to see us like Regina. So funny. Alright! That was really fun. That was a good opening into the theme. I think that's something that I have to just say real quick that I really appreciate about this era coming from Doja is that it really is so perfectly themed. And every visual, every performance, it has all gone within that world. Like, it feels like it all fits together. It's not just putting out a project. I mean, if we really want to talk real quick, let's talk about how she was ball and chain in these shackles to perform Say So 7,000 times. But guess who never got bored of hearing Say So? Me. I still think of the Rock performance of Say So. I think we moved on from that a little too quickly, if I'm being honest. Little vocal moments and I can really appreciate that. She's very versatile. I really like that it continues the sound of the first song. I think just from the other singles I have heard, we are going to explore a lot of different sounds and a lot of different genres as well. I really want to see the evolution of the sound if it does flow throughout the album and it changes really nicely and it's not too jarring. That's something I'm gonna be on the lookout for. This song, I don't know how it's gonna be in my ranking. Like, I think it's fun, but it might be one that has to grow on me a little bit. I don't know, because like, I've heard the singles, I know Love to Dream's coming. Like, I feel like there's so many strong songs on this that this one, I don't know if it holds up. I already love that. Bye. Why did I hear like Jacob in the background? Okay, that's better. That was a little jarring hearing him so high pitched. Don't know how I feel about that. Oh my god, you guys, I am brilliant. Doja, hire me for the next album. You know who should have been on this? Cause I was just thinking to myself, I'm like, the high pitch on his voice, not really a vibe, but you know who it is a vibe with? T-Pain. You know who should have been on this song? T-Pain. This man can sing. And when he does the little effects, it's never overdone. It sounds perfect. It's adding to the vocals that are already there. Bitch, I'm brilliant. Bilingual talking money conversations. I love that. Bilingual talking money talking conversation. I like the gist of this too. Just kind of being like, she's getting her due, essentially. Like, Doja has worked so hard. And it's kind of funny because, you know, people think that she started from Moo. That's not the case whatsoever. That's just kind of what put her in the spotlight. Doja's been around and she works for what she has. Not to sit here and like just completely kiss her ass, but it's time for her payday. It's time for everyone to give her the respect that she deserves. This chorus is so fun. I see why everyone's been talking about Miss Payday. I do still stand. I think T-Pain would have fit better on the song if we're doing all the vocal effects, but still really good. That chorus is so infectious. It's just so good. It's just a good vibe. Next one, get into it. Yeah. Where's Ariana? Honest to God, I think that that is Ariana's brand now. Yeah. Honestly, Ariana fans, real quick, let's play a fun game. Fun game. When I say yeah, what is the first song that comes to mind from her? For me personally, it's God is a Woman. Have it any way you like, ya. Get into it. It's the shortest song, a little over 2 minutes. Another one. Another one. Why was that giving me like... This is gonna sound awful. If Lin... How do you say his name? Lin... Manuel Miranda? Him. I feel like if he was writing the music for Annie, it would have sounded like that. No way! Would you say call him Ed Sheeran because he's in love with my body? Period. We love a pop culture reference. I need an Ariana one though. Like, her brand is in the title. Out here saying that Doja is a fake Barb. She is not. She is a Barb through and through. I remember watching, there was like a little bit of a clip of her live stream from when she was playing Little Nightmares, and she, like, I don't know why her being in stress mode resulted in her doing Nicki Minaj songs. Like, it was the best thing I've ever seen. It was so funny.
This one is definitely not for the boys with the booming system because, bitch, I'm the source. I'm the boss.
I don't know, I kind of appreciate that because as much as people hate to say it, I think Nicki did open a lot of doors for women and is kind of the one that paved the way for a lot of these up and coming artists. Is that controversial to say? It shouldn't be, it's just the truth. The song, however, I don't know. Feel like I need to be drunk and hear it. But sober, boring ass me right now? No. Need to know, girl. There's crack in this song, that's all I gotta say. I just been fantasizing. I heard from a friend of a friend that dick was a 10 out of 10. I don't wanna see y'all. I swear to God, I'm gonna post this and this is gonna be towards the top of my ranking and y'all are gonna come after me for that.
Listen.
When an album comes out, that does not mean you need to shit on all the singles. Some of them are singles for a reason. They're just good. So if I see you disrespecting Need to Know, we're gonna have to have a conversation, okay? This song is so good. And I'm tired of liking singles and you guys being like,
that song's actually trash.
I know we're excited because we have other new songs, but damn, it's okay to like a single. All right, oh, next one is the one with my girl, I Don't Do Drugs, featuring Ariana Grande. Same, don't do drugs. 3 minutes, I'm expecting vocals. I'm expecting me to pass away. Yes, 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 yes. What is with this wolf? Is it like a producer thing? It's not like a physical drug. It's being addicted to a person, and that is your drug. Got it. I hear her. Come on. But you fucking me up on this FaceTime. Saying the nastiest shit and sounding so beautiful while she does it. Hold on. I heard something about hitting it from the back. I mean, I can't be surprised. Like, if you know Ariana, she's a dirty little bird. And we love that for her. Like, this is nothing new. Y'all, have y'all heard Cinderella? So, baby, can you hit it from the back? Got me purring like I'm Doja Cat. That is so fun. That is so clever. This is definitely more my speed, more my sound compared to some of the other ones we have heard so far. Oh my god. I am disgusted. My song. Oh my god. How are you gonna do I Don't Do Drugs and then go into Love to Dream like that? Ooh, I legitimately just got chills. Oh, what a collab. What a moment. What a vibe.
I'm dying.
Do I have to say anything else? I don't think so, because I've lost all train of thought, because Love to Dream is gonna be playing. So excuse the person I'm about to become for the next 3.5 minutes. I mean, for you, it'll probably be like 20 seconds, but for 3.5 minutes for me. Oh, I'm so excited. No one talked to me. Not love that chorus. How do you hear that chorus and think, it's okay? Do I need to make an appointment for you to get your hearing checked? Because we are not hearing the same thing. This chorus is godly. That's it. Oh yeah, the Tinashe name drop. Girl, Tinashe really is just that girl. It's funny how she gets so much love from other artists and other creatives, and the general public is still sleeping. Like, what do y'all sleep on? Because I don't sleep on Tinashe. Oh, and that ending note. Okay. God, help me. Just know the second this camera turns off and I start importing my files, we're gonna go play her. Next one, You Right. So this one I know has a visual. Used to watch the visual with you guys in these videos, but YouTube has been so weird with visual copyright claims. So I'll watch it in my own time and I'll leave a little note here. This is what I think of it, even though I already know it's gonna be visuals. Yes, girl, I need some M&Ms. Hold on. I cannot believe this shit I'm hearing. I'm hungry. She's feeding me, and yet I'm hungry. How ungrateful am I? I cannot believe what I am hearing. This is ridiculous. This is beyond ridiculous. I'm getting mad now. I'm getting mad. Because how? Literally how? You know what? I'm gonna sit here and finish this while eating my M&Ms. Mm-hmm. Oh my god! Ooh. The way she she can switch so effortlessly into like singing voice and her rapping voice. I don't know how else to describe it. I'm sure there's like actual terminology, but she's just so good at what she does. And this one is so vulnerable too. I mean, they all have had like a sense of vulnerability. This one I think goes a little bit deeper into what the relationship was like or what, you know, was going on, what the problem was with it after it ended. I don't know, I really appreciate this one lyrically. Sonically as well, but. Whoa, what an abrupt end. Why? You can count on me to never count on you. Damn. Why'd that hurt? This later half of the album is a little bit more vulnerable. We had a lot of fun in the beginning. We were introducing the concept. We were getting digged down, and now we're thinking. It's the thought afterwards. In a way, I guess, we kind of have gone through a cycle of a relationship. Now that I'm really thinking about the lyrical content. You know, I think this is an album that can get kind of, that can get hidden because of the production and how fun it is or different features. But if you really think about it, it's like, oh damn, we actually are going on a story. Like we're going on a ride. I already can see the comments being like, you know, her talking about like, men ain't shit. Well, people look at that statement and they're like, you're immature, like you need to get out of this mindset if you ever want a man.
Well, maybe find me a man that is good. Acting like that cause your dad's a bitch. Must be the way that the plan is. Can't give head
with you, ain't shit, need a laxative. She just ended everyone's life, as she should.
Good for her. Go get your car, I'll call your fucking mom. Fuck
it, yeah. Who the hell pissed her off this much? My God. You should have paid my rent, go get a job. I'm gonna call your mom. Oh my God. Anyway, next one is Imagine. We're actually almost done with the standard part of the album. I'm a little worried about the deluxe just because I've talked to you guys about before. I'm not a huge fan of deluxe tracks usually. Most of the time I listen to them and I think to myself, there's a reason this isn't on the standard, but it'll be interesting to listen to it. So let's finish this off. We are again at Imagine, 2.5 minutes. Let's go. Okay. I mean, I was gonna feel bad for any song that came after Ain't Shit because that's the bar, right? Like the bar is pretty high now, but I think even wherever this was in the album, it's not gonna be my favorite. I don't like the really stressed out words on top of having like the vocal effect on it. I don't know, it's not vibing. Not a vibe so far, but let me finish it. Hold on. I don't mind the chorus. Little guitar moment, okay. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh no.
Did she write my song? Did she just give me my song? This production. Holy shit. Something I guess I really have noticed and really appreciate, and especially these like later half of the songs, the production feels really full. You know, because a lot of music today is not necessarily produced with real instruments and not to sound just so fucking annoying. So for this to be produced at the way it is and sound so full is actually really impressive. And I don't know, I think it's really shining on this song. I actually really like this song. Wow. Thinking that you're scared of yourself, not me. Impossible from a predator, but being lonely better than needs control. Cherish it. Wow, that one was so good. I still have Love to Dream stuck in my head. God damn. God Damn, I love that song. Okay, we are gonna finish off the standard edition with Kiss Me More, so we're gonna quickly bop to this. I love this part. Okay, so the next one is You Write, the extended version. So I don't know if I'm gonna be able to pick up exactly what is extended from this song since I've only heard it once, but let's give it a go. Might quickly go through this one. Is it this part? That's new? I have to say it's really smart for the point of Billboard and tracking to release the extended version, especially if they're pushing this as a single. The amount of streams that they're gonna see on streaming services, because everyone's gonna be checking out the deluxe tracks. That deluxe tracks. There we go. It's smart business. I mean, I was very surprised to see a deluxe edition drop already, but at the same time, I'm not, because most of the time when you drop an album, if there is a deluxe edition, it either comes like a month or so after it's dropped, or it gets dropped the same day, so. Interesting, this one's the opposite of a lot of my problems with the other songs. I really like the verse, but I don't care for the chorus. And I'm a big chorus girl, honestly. Like, I'll suffer through the verses to get to a good chorus. Anytime, every time, all the time. You know what's so funny about this song is that it's not bad whatsoever, but you compare it to the other tracks on the album and it's like, oh, I see why this one didn't quite make it. I am actually not mad at this one at all. I have to say, I think this one's my favorite so far out of the deluxe tracks. I would rather have this than, what was it? Is it Imagine? Yeah, I'd rather have this over Imagine, like, any day. You know what? For them being deluxe tracks, they are probably some of the best deluxe tracks I've heard. Again, they're not bad by any means, but you just compare them to what is on the standard album and it's like, sorry, bud. You know, the bar was all the way up here. I'm like losing my voice, can you hear it? Overall thoughts though, she came and delivered. Quite a few standout tracks that I'm just gonna gravitate towards the second this camera is off and you already know which ones they are. There are a few that I hope kind of grow on me. There are a few that I'm probably gonna skip, especially like within the deluxe. If anything, I think this just solidified her as an artist and how versatile she is and how creative she is. Like, who is doing what she is doing with this era? We need more artists to do eras like this, Future Nostalgia, After Hours by The Weeknd. Like, these are some great eras that, like, conceptually, visually, everything is just where it needs to be. So with all that being said, this is my current ranking right now of the album. A little scared because I don't know, I have a feeling not a lot of people are gonna agree with me. What's new? But let me know in the comments down below what your ranking is and what your favorites are. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, go check out my other channels for different type of content from me. I love you, take care of yourself, and I will see you in the next one.